Welcome, I'm Larry Seaman for Salem Community Television. And we're at Veterans Common to celebrate the annual tree lighting ceremony here in 2013. Now, I understand there's some changes going on with the Lions Club, who are sponsoring this event. So we're going to talk a little bit about that. So let's take a look and see what we can find.
Now it's my great pleasure to introduce Lions President and State Rep Bob Elliott.
Just two things. Number one, thank you all very much for coming out with all of these children tonight. This is a glorious night, and this is the passing of the torch from Ann to Carol, and Ann's been doing this for the past 15 or 20 years, and we really appreciate it, and a hand for her. And the second thing is, I want to thank everyone who's here tonight and all of the people in the town of Salem for their generous contributions time after time to all of our fundraising efforts to be of service to our fellow man. Total of giving this year for the Salem Lions Club to the whole community was over $50,000, and we thank you very much for that. Thank you.
And now I'd like to welcome our guest speaker tonight, Salem Selectman Pat Hargreaves.
Thank you and welcome. When I was asked to be guest speaker tonight, I was sitting back saying, sure, it'd be my honor. But I didn't know what I was going to talk about. And my wife looked at me and said, just talk about what you feel. And if I said that, they wouldn't invite me again. So what happened over the past weekend was me, my wife, and my two grandchildren, Aiden and Evan, we went to North Conway and we went on the Polar Express. And I'm sitting back on the train watching my two grandkids drinking hot chocolate, listening to the stories, heading up to North Pole, walking up to Santa's Village, watching Santa Claus talk to my grandkids, coming back, a little elf named Holly. She was talking to my grandson, Aiden. My grandson, Aiden, is very shy. He's not an outspoken person like some people we know. And Holly leaned over and talked to my grandson and said, hi, my name's Holly, and I'm 123 years old, and my birthday is December 25th, and I'll be 124. And she said that she's in charge of all the decorating of the North Pole. And at that time, my grandson, Aiden, looked up at her and started talking to her like they were best friends. We got back on the train, we went back to the hotel, and the following day, we went up on a sleigh ride. The sleigh ride was about an hour and a half late. It was 6:30 at night, and I'm sitting next to a campfire warming up, watching my two grandsons skate on a little patch of ice no more than 3 feet wide. And they're playing. I'm just standing there minding my own business. And as parents, we don't intermingle. We don't say hi to another stranger. We just keep an eye on our kids. I'm watching my grandkids play, and I'm saying to myself, this is what Christmas is all about. Watching my grandkids enjoy the holiday season. At that time, I'm thinking about this, my grandson and another boy fell. And as most boys do, when you fall, you grab. And he grabbed this young boy, and well, they hit the ice together. They got up. They were shaking, cried a little bit, shook it off, and they continued playing. At that time, I looked at the gentleman next to me and said, your son's pretty good, and he had an accent. So I'm looking at him, and we began talking and find out that he was from Yorkshire, England. And that's where my ancestors came from. I told him what my last name was, Hargreaves. He looked at me and goes, I go to a pet store. Hargreaves' pet store in Yorkshire, England. That's where my ancestors were. Small world. We kept on talking, watching our young kids play. The sleigh comes up. We get on the sleigh ride. They're on a different sleigh ride. All of a sudden, we're on another sleigh ride with eight other people, parents and kids. Don't know anybody. My littlest grandson, Evan, starts talking. The gentleman in front of me, we start talking. We're like a family on a sleigh ride. The Christmas spirit is all around us. Whether the couple in front of us was African American, the couple behind them was Asian, it didn't matter. We all had one simple communication, and that was the grandkids, Christmas spirit, and brotherhood. That's what we had. After the sleigh ride, we looked at each other, we said our goodbyes, and that was the night. If you take anything from my story, it's a true story. It really happened to me. And my grandkids saved Christmas for myself. Because I did not know the true meaning of Christmas as an adult. We see our kids, we go to the stores, we buy our kids everything in the world. We buy them iPads, iPhones, tablets, whatever our kids need, and we forget what we're really there for. We're there to have memories of our grandkids, of our kids, and that's what I hope and wish for all of you here tonight. Wish you all a Merry Christmas, Happy New Year, and please, hug one another once in a while. Nobody's going to hit you. Good night, ladies and gentlemen. Love you.
Thank you so much, Pat. That was such a good story. I know my heart's warm. I'm sure everybody's in the Christmas spirit now. All of us Lions would like to wish everybody a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year, and peace be with you. And now we're ready for Paul to light the tree. Thank you.